So I focus on robotic manipulation, which is the art and science of how do we enable systems to physically interact with the world. So you can imagine our research as encompassing anything to do with hands and how robots can touch the world, edit it, modify it. How do they combine vision and touch, and how do they build 3D models of the world that help them reason and act? So having robotic assistants that will be able to step in and help you cook, not take over cooking, but do the things that you don't want to do, like wash your dishes or put things away, bring things out. That'd be really amazing. The one problem that I'm really, really excited about right now is robotic tool use. So this means thinking about questions like, what is a tool? How does a robot recognize what a tool is? How should a robot grasp a tool? How should it think about the tool in different situations? Can it use a hammer, for example, not just for hammering, but for also opening a door? It's really about thinking about geometry, deformations, touch, forces, all the kinds of things that we think are really cool. First, we believe in building models and then taking action using those models. A lot of the field also thinks about, what if I don't build 3D explicit models? What if my models are implicit learned end-to-end? I don't have so much of an end-to-end worldview. I think that being able to think about the world and then act on it is a much more plausible way for AI to step into the world. We've also recently developed this tactile sensor that we're open sourcing. It's part of our effort to democratize tactile sensing, both for the hobbyist and for the researcher.